Okay, just another brief update. I've finished the car, the rear. I've bled the brakes, I've taken it for a drive. I'm not so sure that the brakes are completely bled. I put the car back in the garage at a slight angle because I think the clutch needs bleeding, and yeah, that could do with new fluid as well, I think. And the what can I say, car was took it for about a 5 mile run. The car was quite stable in temperature. Obviously I had to be careful because I've got no front indicators or number plate. So the plan is to bleed the clutch and do the front bumper. I'll show you what the problem is with the front bumper at the moment, and the engine smelling quite nice. Now the front bumper, what I've got is, I know the car's looking a bit dirty, please excuse that, and with the main girder, you've got the impact bumpers, and basically the plastic comes out over this, but what you can do is you can pull this out a bit like this. This side, it's completely okay. Not sure if I'll be able to show you that, but I'll try, because the rear, or the bolts securing it to the main front chassis members, or the body members, has actually split. Let's get the light in there for a minute, see if I can see that. Now, here's, we're going to put the light, let's put the light there. Be able to see that if I put that on the ground. Contortionist. Now you see this here. Oh, dogs. There, that's not supposed to come away. And that technically is glued on. I think that would be an MOT failure if I did have to. Let me see it. There's the centre post there, you can see where it pivots on. So it's not exactly gonna fall off. And yeah, and you've got the two bolts there, like, yeah, bolt and nut switch cap, and that's supposed to hold it to completely tightly on. So I'm gonna have to get this front girder off again and see what I can do with it. And this part here is actually like some really stiff rubber compound here. And again, it's just perished. I can't find any of these spares at all, unless I get hold of somebody that's actually going to scrap a 7. But yeah, and you can see under the front wing that needs to rub down, and the wings themselves have been repaired long ago by the looks of it, because the paint is starting to fade on one wing. That's not so bad this side. It's not so bad this side, but as you can see, some blemishes are starting to come out. Now, the passenger side, you'll be able to see that discoloration there where the paint has been so thin. And it's just over the last 13 years or so, it's, and it's gone. And yeah, so I haven't cleaned the car. I thought whilst I'm still doing this, there's no point if I'm rubbing stuff down. I'll give it all a good clean, but I'm gonna have to rub down those wings, I think, and the driver's door, typical problem. Might need a new skin at some point. Where's I do the torch? Don't know. And yeah, she's starting to bubble down here a bit. Not sure we'll be able to see that. Yeah, just down here. Let's get the torch again. Like I was saying a few times ago, that the whole thing needs a complete respray, really. You can see there on the doors. Yes, that's a typical problem they had. But if you look in the bonnet here, you can see inside the bonnet there's all this real this wax oil stuff, which has saved the car. It's all over the place. And it was all over the back of this bonnet as well, and all over the engine bay too, and I cleaned it all off. But I'm not going to clean inside here. Obviously it has protected the metal from ingress of moisture and the rust. It's all down the sides here in the channel, water channels. That's still there. But yeah, so the next plans probably then is to get the get that bumper sorted at least, or get it off. And dare I say, I did, whilst I was bleeding the brakes, I did the front as well, because I put some complete new brake fluid in it. And yeah, it's let's have a quick shifty under the wheel arch, because I said, you know, like the back, it's all pretty good, and it's just looking a bit aged. And do I want to go to town on this as well? And then once I do that, I'm going to end up, you know, either taking the engine out, but then the steering rack doesn't look too bad, but then it's just looking a bit grimy and dirty from what it was 13 odd years ago. So yeah, I don't know, it was like, it's a bit wet down there, and I think where the under there is the fuel pump, and I think it's just seeping from the gasket there. There's a metal and a cork gasket on let's go over here, down there. You can see it's a bit wet there, so once I've got it up to a bit of pressure, unless you must be squeezing out. I don't think it's petrol, so I think that is seeping oil slightly. So yeah, I've got a mat down there just to make sure I can sort of see where it's coming from. But apart from that, everything else is nice and dry. Yeah, no leaks of water or anything anywhere. Nope. So, yeah. That's just more cosmetics again, basically. Like I said, I'll have to bleed the clutch, I think, and stick some new fluid in there. There's the master cylinder there. But the bleed point for the, as anyone knows, sevens, the bleed point is actually on the slave cylinder down below, which is on the side of the, near the starter, I think. Yeah, once again underneath, I'll see it straight away. So yeah, that's the plan, to bleed that, replace the clutch fluid. And saying that, I'm sure there's enough in there, because I did check. I will just check to make sure. Yes, completely topped up, looking quite clean, that machine. Yep. So I will do that. Yeah. So that's it for now, just a brief update, I said, and going to town again. So I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. Bye now.